Welcome to the Columbus State Library's tutorial for SIRS Issues Researcher. SIRS Issues Researcher is one of the 200 databases students and staff can access through the Columbus State Library's website. It's notable particularly for its depth and breadth, and is especially useful for students who have to do a thesis and support paper, where you make an argument and then back up your argument with facts. To access SIRS Issues Researcher, you'll want to go ahead and open a web browser. We recommend Google Chrome or Firefox. Either one is fine. If necessary, make the browser full screen by clicking the center button at the upper right of the browser. And then to visit the library's website, which is our next step, you'll want to click once in the address bar, delete any text that's there, and type the library's web address. That's library.cscc.edu. Go ahead and hit enter when you've done that. Over on the left-hand side near the top is a link for find books and articles. You want to go ahead and click on that. And then under find articles, click on databases. The database list that loads is alphabetical, and we've got SIRS listed under the S's, so go ahead and click on the letter S, and then scroll down just a bit until you get to SIRS Issues Researcher. If you're working off campus, you'll be prompted at this point to enter your name and your Cougar ID number in order to get access to the database. That's standard for all of our electronic resources, because they're only available to Columbus State staff and current students. A quick aside, there is something at the upper right here of the database page that says Educators Resources. They're not particularly relevant for students. They have things like curriculum ideas and tutorials for using the database that are primarily of interest to instructors. Now, as far as actually navigating SIRS Issues Researcher, there's several ways. As you can see, there's a search box and even an advanced search. We'll go into that in a little bit. There's a leading issues menu, which is very, very helpful. We'll also explore that. And there's even two horizontal bars here of trending topics and then something called editor's picks. So trending topics and editor's picks are things that have been selected by the database providers. Trending topics are things that are currently being argued about. So there's lots of debate about them at present that might be of particular interest to students. Editor's picks are issues that, yes, they may be current, but they also have been longstanding issues a lot of the time. There's going to be a lot of information about them. You could write a pretty meaty paper about those. So instead of clicking on any of these, I'll show you how to get to even more of these topics. They have them under leading issues, which is up at the upper left of the screen here. If you click on that, you'll see a variety of subtopics, and then you'll even see all leading issues. So you can take a look at all of them at once. This page looks really similar to the one we were just at, and if you look around, you'll see that that's because it's sorted by trending. These are, again, issues that are currently under debate, have been updated really recently. Those are things that are very attractive to students a lot of the time. We also, here at the very sort of center top, have a list of those subtopics. Those are the ones you saw in that initial leading issues menu. And then as you scroll down, you'll see lots and lots of different topics you could explore. So what happens when you click on one of these? We'll click on homework as an example. So what SIRS does is give you a summary of the issue, and you can actually unfold that by clicking read full summary. They try to give you a little bit of background about the topic, and then as you scroll down the page here, they give you some suggestions for ways you can argue about the topic. This can be really helpful for a thesis and support paper, especially if you're interested in a topic but aren't completely sure how you want to discuss it yet. As you scroll down a bit more, they have these critical questions and sometimes an amusing political cartoon. The critical questions, though, are helpful for getting you to think critically and engage with your topic. And again, that can spark some really good ideas for writing. The timeline for a topic is especially useful if a topic has been debated for a long time or has some kind of lengthy historical background. It gives you the context you need to write in an educated way about your topic. So if you go all the way up to the top, there's some functionality in SIRS that you'll see in pretty much every article or summary that it provides for you. It's over here on the right. There's a box that says, use this document. It does offer you ways to save the document to the cloud. Many students use Google Drive, for instance, so you can drop it right in your Google Drive. It offers you a printable version, and it says that you can email it to yourself. We do want to bring your attention to the fact that it does offer citation help. This is very useful for students. When you click on Cite, a pop-up box appears with an MLA 8 citation. So if that's not the format you're using, make sure you click on the citation style option and select the correct one. You can copy and paste these citations into maybe an email or some document to keep track of it for yourself. But before using them in your final paper, it's a very good idea to double check these. They're not always completely correct. So let's go back to SIRS Issues Researcher's front page. We're going to click on the logo at the upper left. And we're back to our front page now. And let's try a search for a known topic. Let's say you wanted to do a paper on whether or not college athletes should be paid. You can go ahead and search for it here in the search box, but we actually like to recommend the advanced search. I'll click on that. It's searchable in much the same way, but this just gives you a way to, for instance, limit things by publication date. You can make it very recent. You can tell it to do a custom date range from maybe a certain year forward. It can be really nice. It also makes it very clear what resources it will be pulling back. We recommend initially letting it stay on all resources and all dates, just so you can get a full picture of what's really out there. You can always refine your search after it's been done. Before you actually type your search into the bar, what you want to do is pare your research question or thesis down into a couple of important words, because you can't enter full sentences or questions into the database's search bar. So our question, our research question is, should college athletes get paid? So the core words in there are college, athletes, and pay. Let's try entering that into our search bar. You'll notice that the database does suggest some other things you could search with. You don't have to do those. You can ignore them for now. Sometimes they do come up with great ideas, but none of them seem to fully encapsulate what you're trying to search for. So if you're ready to search, you click on the magnifying glass or just hit enter on your keyboard. And as you can see, we have over 1,000 results. The results come up with a title for each article, and then they do tell you the author and the newspaper, if relevant, and the date. They tell you what type of source it is. And then over here on the left-hand side, it gives you an idea of how many of each type of source was returned. If you're particularly interested, for instance, in looking at scholarly journals, you can click on scholarly journals and it will only pull those up for you. It's very helpful. You can also click the little X by scholarly journals to go ahead and go back to your primary list, your first list. So now we're back at our initial search results. If you notice, you can here on the bottom left, go ahead and tell it that you want to search within a certain date range. That's useful if you've looked over your search results and find a lot of things that are addressing the topic in a way that's very out of date. Anytime you want to look at any of these articles, all you need to do is click on the article title. The article is right there in full text. It's the original